Are you vaccinated, and what's your stance on vaccinations?
Yeah, I've been immunized.
This is the quote that set the NFL ablaze yesterday.
Well, there is big news tonight in the NFL. Green Bay Packers quarterback Aaron Rodgers is benched after testing positive for COVID. And there are new questions about whether Rodgers violated the league's COVID protocols.
So you may be thinking, he said he's immunized. How could he violate COVID protocols?
You know, there's guys on the team that haven't been vaccinated. I think it's a personal decision. I'm not going to judge those guys. There's guys who have been vaccinated that contracted COVID.
He did the usual song and dance of folks who are vaccine hesitant, which at this point we know all too well.
Rodgers has conducted weekly and post-game news conferences in person and without wearing a mask, while Packers players who are unvaccinated participate in media sessions on Zoom. Under NFL protocols, unvaccinated players are subject to a $14,000 fine if they refuse to wear a mask or maintain social distancing. Repeat violations can lead to a 4-game suspension.
Guys, this is a massive story. A star player potentially lying about his vaccination status and putting others in harm's way. In short, the NFL's COVID protocols are there to protect everyone. That, again, so is the vaccine. Here's what we know. The reigning MVP had an alternate treatment prior to the start of training camp, sources told ESPN, and he then petitioned the NFL for that treatment to allow him to be considered the same as someone who received one of the approved vaccinations. This approach, per NFL Network's Ian Rappaport, was a homeopathic or holistic immunization treatment, which he thought might be able to get him vaccinated status. After a lengthy back and forth, the league, the players' union, and an infectious disease consultant approved by both parties heard Rodgers' case for an exemption and ruled that he would not get the same consideration and would be considered unvaccinated. Thus, since the start of the season, the NFL has considered Rodgers as unvaccinated. Many are looking for answers. Some brought up quotes from Rodgers' fiancée, actress Shailene Woodley. In 2014, Woodley told Flaunt magazine, quotes of which were printed via ABC News, "I make my own medicines. I don't get those from my doctors. I make my own cheese and forage wild foods and identify wild plants. It's an entire lifestyle. It's appealing to my soul. I think everything about my lifestyle is fairly alternative." One outlet even called Woodley our dream holistic healer. All in all, we don't have the direct admission because Rodgers refuses to do so, but we can follow what has been made public. Rodgers spent this past offseason traveling to Hawaii as an unvaccinated tourist with his fiancée. Both were seen without masks in clear violation of the state's mask mandate. Recall Miles Teller, the Hollywood actor who refused the vaccine and brought COVID to a set, shutting down the film and hurting the crew. Yep, Rodgers and Woodley hung out with Teller and his wife in Hawaii and at the Kentucky Derby, maskless. Most recently, Rodgers attended a Halloween party with teammates. His positive test came just days later. Per Pro Football Talk's Mike Florio, Rodgers has been seen not wearing a mask during preseason or on the sidelines. Per NFL policy, unvaxxed players are required to wear masks indoors at all times except while eating. The question remains, what will the NFL do? This is the case of a star player, an MVP, the face of the franchise, and the most important leadership position on the team violating COVID protocols. As ESPN's Kevin Seifert noted, the Packers could face more culpability. Past teams that were fined were the Saints, Raiders, Titans, New England, and Baltimore. The Saints were also stripped of a 7th-round draft pick, and the Raiders lost a 6th-rounder. The Post Sally Jenkins pen, may he make a speedy return to the Green Bay Packers with no symptoms, but as for sympathy, that should be diverted to people who shared spaces with him when he was unmasked, who now have to sit around and wonder whether they brought something home because he was too coy with the coronavirus.